Today we continue on the rewire at Lineside Studios. We've got Pegasus Electrical back, so that means Eddie and Steve are with us, and we're going to produce a couple of videos to add to the series that we've already started. We've already done a video on the Legrand Salamander trunking, and if you haven't already checked that one out, it'll be in the description or the eye above my head. But today, Eddie is going to be concentrating on the Schneider Acti 9 isobar P distribution board, so we'll have a look at what he's doing and see if we can pick up some more top tips. There will be another video with Steve, who's currently fabricating the basket system from Accor and installing that also within Lineside Studio. So again, I recommend you check out that video. Shall we see what Eddie's up to? You've cleared the board, Eddie, and you're looking at configuring some of the devices. Are you marrying together a breaker and an RCD now?
Yes, correct, Gary. I've got to remove this tab here, which exposes the keyway for them to interlock.
Ah, right.
There we go, like that.
I think I remember that from the video we did, yeah, and then yeah. They should drop into each other, yeah.
That there goes into there. Be careful of this little tab over here, yeah.
So that's now got a 30 milliamp RCD now married with a 40 amp breaker, where it was before with a 16, is that right?
That's correct, yes.
So that keyway will line itself up. See that go into there. And they'll click together, yeah.
Oh, there we go. There we go.
Okay. And now your screws are going to do up at the bottom here and obviously interconnect the neutral. Are you going to do those to the required torque setting now, or is it something you do later on?
No, I do them later on, Gary. So that at the end of the job, when I'm ready to start commissioning, everything's torqued up at once. That way then I know everything's torqued up and I haven't forgotten anything.
Otherwise you end up going over it two or three times thinking, yeah. Have I done everything? Yeah. I see you've been taking some of the neutral links out within the board itself as well for the configuration. Do you think you've got it in the right order now?
Yes, I believe so.
So we can pop this one straight into the board?
Tabs are back. Including that front one. And that should make it a bit easier to go in, like so.
So Eddie, you've removed the interconnecting links from the isolating switch and the connecting point there on the distribution board. And what are you doing with them?
I decided I was going to colour code them up for identification.
Okay, and you've got your heat gun out, so we're going to see that in action. I notice that like all your tools are in your hand, they're usually Milwaukee. Here we go then, see you do the heat gun. So this is the main incoming switch, and they're the flexible connections you've made for the DB and they're color coordinated. But I think I found another little secret you've got there, because last video I did with you, Steve did all the work, and I think Louis did it this time, but I'm sure you're gonna take the credit for that one, yeah?
Of course.
So I can see the surge protection device there. How is that gonna be connected in relationship to the incoming supply?
That would be paralleled from the surge protection over to the isolator.
Okay, well, we've had a look at that, and I think that deserves a standalone video, so we're going to do that separately. So if you want to check that one out again, it'll be in the link in the description or the eye above the screen on this one. I take it the cables are in next, is that right?
Yes, we're going to start dressing in the cables, bringing them into the distribution board and dressing them up the sides.
So we'll have some top tips maybe on how to dress those single cables to make the best looking board possible. Ed's dressing his cables into his Schneider Acti 9 isobar P distribution board. These are single insulated cables, so they're always more tricky to look neat. He's also getting them on the appropriate side for the overcurrent protection device that is already installed. So we've seen you pull all the cables in and got them loosely dressed into the right position, but I'm noticing some cable tie bases have been stuck to the back of the DB and you've pulled a cable tie onto them. What's your thinking behind that?
Just to dress them up the side of the board so they're tidier, easier to work with.
And how tight are you going to pull that cable tie when you're finished?
I tend to leave them loose, so it makes it easier for later on when you're doing periodic testing and also for no overheating on the grouping.
Okay, and then we're going to, from this position here, you'll just swing them into the appropriate overcurrent protection devices?
I tend to go past the device and then swing back into them. Just gives you a bit of extra cable if you ever need, and also easier again for periodic testing.
Yeah, so in periodic testing we're looking at maybe moving a conductor just to confirm where it goes. Is that what you're thinking is?
That's it, yeah, or if you need to, doing an R1, R2 test, you can easily get the cables from one place to the other.
You've connected your first three phase and neutrals into the RCBO element of that device. I like the way you've swooped it up and back down again. It looks really neat. Which one are you going to do next?
The next one, I've got a 40 amp single phase, which has also got the neutral coming through the overcurrent protective device.
So it's a double pole breaker. Shall we swing that one in next? I like that trick of going up and dressing it back down. It is difficult to make PVC singles look neat within a distribution board, but that looks great.
I always do the top one first. More so that the other one follows afterwards. You get that one right and then the rest follow correctly. Square them up as we go along.
I think that looks neat, bringing them up and down and using those cable tie bases in order to hold the cables together. It is notoriously difficult, isn't it, with PVC singles to make them look anything within a distribution board. That looks good. We're at the stage now where we're going to look at doing the torque of our devices, and I'm looking through your set here. We haven't got one, we haven't got two, but we've actually got four torque screwdrivers. Eddie, what's the thinking behind that?
So we've got the full range of settings for terminals, as well as MCBs and RCDs and RCBOs and such like.
So you've selected this one here, which is 0.8 to 3 newton meters of torque. We've got one here for very low torque settings, and we've got one over here that does 1 to 5 newton meters of torque. Have you ever set them up where you've had a couple of screwdrivers done in a distribution board so you can swap between them without changing?
Yeah, more for control panels, because you've got the relays, you've got the MCBs and such like. They've all got different torque settings.
So as it's a digital one, you're going to have to set it up. How does that happen?
On the button we press on the back, it's currently set at 2.2.
Yeah.
Push the button on the bottom of the handle, and then we can adjust the setting up or down.
Okay, and you're going for 2 newton meters of torque for the RCBOs, is that right?
That's correct, yeah.
Well, that's a fine adjustment, isn't it?
Yes.
You've changed your Weha digital torque screwdriver to a different one, and what torque setting are we going to now set it to?
We're going to be setting it to 3.5, Gary.
Okay, so let's wind it up to 3.5. Something quite satisfying about doing that, and then look at that.
Touch back, there we go.
So what's the thinking about returning these torque settings then?
We need to set them to the manufacturer's instructions.
And how can I find that out in this DB?
This DB actually has a sticker inside the DB to show you the settings for the terminal bars, the MCBs, RCBOs.
Well, We'd like to thank Eddie from Pegasus Electrical for coming down and connecting up our Schneider distribution board. Is there any top tips in there that you didn't know that you might be using in the future? Have you got any of your own? Please leave those in the comments below. Are you the sort of person that likes to talk up your terminals, or you don't believe in it? That's feedback we'd also like. If you can leave those in the comments, we'll try and get back to as many as we can.